really fast. Yep. All of them are just the running backs.
They got good speed everywhere. It's Florida team. You're always going to have that. So obviously the two backs are extremely fast. They get on the edges pretty quick. And even when people got them leveraged outside in, they'll run around the leverage players on the defense. So it's got to be something we've emphasized all week, and we have. And tackling is going to be a huge part of it.
That speed, maybe the same with the schemes are different the way they're using Charlie Weiss. How big the difference is that?
You got a ton of formations. He obviously is excellent at what he does. And so you do research on Coach Weiss, and throughout his tenure, he's got every play and formation known to mankind. So, I would assume we're going to see something different than we've already seen.
When you did all that background, did you focus on college stuff? Did you look at pro matter?
Yeah,
all of it.
A lot of games.
How difficult is it to even remotely replicate their speed on the edge out here?
Yeah, you talk about it, you emphasize it, and you put the best guys you can to give you a service look, but it's just there's nothing like that game speed, so that's hard to do.
Just because you're using Jacquez in several different places, his versatility, what that provides for him, and the ability to play nose three all over, what that brings for you.
Yeah, well, Jacquez has got some great qualities, and so we're trying to find different ways to use him and get him isolated in the pass game so he can do his thing. The key there is to give us enough options but not slow things down. So that's always a fine line to work.
How you can get to find somebody who have the ability to play all over the line and maybe not?
I think you see that more and more in today's game. It's like receivers and DBs, you're trying to get receivers on certain DBs for mismatches. We try to do the same thing on defense.
Justin, how do you guys strike a balance between drilling in the need to break down and make sure tackles without, the guys think too much.
Well, yeah, I think, the term breakdown is probably vastly overused, because if you break down in space, if you got 10 yards from you and that one of those running backs, if you break down, you're just going to look bad. So you got to be aggressive to the ball carrier. You got to play with great fundamentals. And the key of it is, we've got to make some one-on-one open field tackles, but we also have got to hunt the football. And if one guy does miss, which you're not going to go through a game and not miss one tackle, even though we want to, that's probably not realistic. So we've got to have, 10 other guys hunting the football. That's what's even more important.
I know it's just through two games, but how much better are you guys tackling this year as opposed to a year ago when you had all those stats?
We'll see. This is going to test us because speed is different. There's still too many. It's hard work. So it's something we're going to work on every day.
How important is it to kind of set the edge? Because it looked like in the first two games they were running kind of sweet.
Yeah, and people, that's obviously with these guys, the edges of the defense is extremely important, keeping leverage on the backs. But there's times even the teams that were playing them had leverage on the backs and they outran the leverage. So, it's sometimes you look at it like, well, why don't they force the ball back? Well, they were trying to, but the guys so fast they outran.
And how much does that mean? What do you guys do with corners having to come up and I guess trying to make those tackles but not –
who's covering the wideouts?
Yeah, that's what I mean. Like,
you got to pick and choose your coverage changeup. That's how you got to be able to set the edges with different people. They'll shift and motion you to try and mess with your leverages and your eyes. So that's extremely important that we're able to get lined up, get our eyes in the right spots, and make sure we have good leverage on the football.
We've heard about on offense, they're going out to a hostile environment. It's going to be loud. They're working on silent snap counts and different things like that. What are the challenges playing in an environment like that has on the defense?
Well, I think it's something new. The difference for us is when we're out there now, it's going to be a little quieter. So the communication should be better. And, when you're at home on, third downs, it's loud, which is great. So, that part of it, then just being at away game, in a place like Florida, which is going to be a great college football environment, and some of our guys that are probably not used to that as much, going and getting their baptism. So we just got to go have a good week of practice so we can go out and cut loose.
Did Randolph take another step forward this past week?
I thought he did a good job. Yeah, Brian's improved each week, and we would expect him to continue to do so.
Justin, sorry for me to ask, is there any true way to simulate the kind of speed?
Not unless you're out there practicing. I heard you're pretty fast.
No, yeah.
It's hard to do. You show them the video. You show them the video so they get an understanding of it. You do some with our scout team as best you can to simulate some of that speed. But until you play them, it's hard to simulate unless you have somebody that fast.
So Devin's not at that little bit? Is he able to run a little bit
maybe,
that fast?
Maybe, there? Yeah, a little bit.
Do you see any improvements from the Florida's quarterback now in this system versus last year?
Yeah, I think he's playing really well. He gets the ball to the right people at the right time. I think he's going, as the coverage dictates it, he's throwing the ball in the right spot. So he's done a good job. He managed the game really well for him. And he can make all the throws.
feel like for going into a third game of the season that there's not really a lot y'all can know about this forward team because they've stayed really vanilla in the first couple of months? They can just kind of run over
Well, vanilla is a relative term because sure. he still gives a lot of formations and motions and shifts, and so I would expect to see something new, you know, other than what we've seen in the first two games. But who knows? And, you know, if you go back and read, like I said, Coach Weiss is excellent at what he does, and so if you go look at 10 games of his, you're going to see every play there is, every formation, shift, and motion. So for us, it's going to be more about playing on principles and getting our eyes right and execute. That's what's most important.
I was about to say, it's kind of a complicated question, I guess, but how do you go about, because you don't want to teach the guys too much in the week that they can't play fast, but there's a lot of things they got to be ready for. How do you find that balance?
Fundamentals. You know, it goes down to fundamentals of your position and also of just schematics. You know, when you're a leverage player, you're a force player, you got to force the football. And what they'll do is they'll shift and motion you and try and mess with your eyes and mess with your leverage. So it's very important for us just to play the techniques we've learned and play the principles within the defensive call and go out and cut it loose so we're not sitting back on our heels.
But guys like Rainey and Reed and Burton, they seem to have a lot of guys that they don't really fit under a position title.
Yeah,
that, you know,
and they play them all over. I mean, you're playing, you know, they could be in a traditional two-back, one-tight-end look in the same personnel group. They might go out to empty or a 10 personnel spread look. So you've got to be able, again, to adjust to all that, you know, just within one personnel group. Some more teams are, hey, when they're in two back, 21 personnel, they're in certain formations. These guys got a lot of multiples because of the types of guys they have.
Have you ever coached against a Weiss offense before?
I don't know. What do you mean?
I mean, against him. I mean, against
Oh, no, I've never played against Coach Weiss. But he's obviously, you know, he's one of the best at what he does, and so it'll be a great challenge for us as a team and as a defense.